Hi everyone, my name is Jake, and today I'd like to share tool tips and tricks on lettering your comic pages. This video will cover advice on lettering, including the fonts, the format, and easy program magic, all of which can be accomplished in Clip Studio Paint. So what is lettering? Lettering is the step of your comic making process in which you add text for dialogue and sound effects. When you letter your comic, you're looking at typeface, font, size, and layout, and you're putting it all together in a way that will shape the impact of your comic. Some letterers practice simple formats while others are more elaborate, but the most important rule to remember is that you want your comic to be readable. You could have the most beautiful, stunning art and composition, but if you make it difficult for your audience to read, you'll lose viewership. It should go without saying that you should have an excellent grasp on the grammar and punctuation rules of the language you're writing in, whether you're a native speaker or not. Consider having a friend check it over if you're unsure, so you won't need to make the corrections later. When you start lettering your pages, you want to think hard about the font you'll use, because you'll be using it for the rest of your comic. You want a font that's readable and complements your art. Avoid fonts like Papyrus, Curls, Chillers, Comic Sans, or anything that takes effort to read. Consider instead a sans serif font, using better examples like Arial or Tahoma. If you intend on publishing your comic, you'll want to make sure it's a font you have permissions to use. You can choose from downloading your own fonts, using your computer defaults, or even writing everything by hand. There's even a way to make font with your own handwriting. So not only is it fast, but it's a personalized touch unique only to you and your comic. Just make sure that it's clean and legible. Clip Studio accesses fonts from your computer, so there's no need to import anything. There is actually a lot of discussion around comic book fonts, so I would highly advise doing some research and seek more professional opinions. Once you've picked out the perfect font, consider setting it as the default in your program so it's easy to access. You can do this by clicking on your text tool, going to Windows, then Subtool Detail, select your font, and select Save All Settings as Default. You can also access the Subtool Detail window by clicking on the lower wrench icon here, and even temporarily lock your settings by clicking the upper wrench icon here. If you have a set of favorite fonts you want to use interchangeably, you can create a font list. Select the text tool, click on the font drop-down menu, and select the gear icon for the settings. From here, you can create and name your own lists and checkmark what fonts to display on those lists, and click OK when you're done. Then you can find that list in the text tool font drop-down menu again, where there's another drop-down menu by the gear tool, titled with the name of your font list. Now that we have our font, we'll move on to the format of our lettering process. When you're ready to place them, you can use Clip Studio's balloon tool and drag them out or freehand them yourself. You can transform and adjust it to fit your panel however you like. Clip Studio also comes with plenty of balloon assets in its materials folder that you can drag and drop and adjust to fit your pages. When you place your balloons, make sure they fit the flow of the comic from top to bottom, whether you're reading from right to left or from left to right, and avoid taking up too much space. Try and keep the balloon lines consistent, and a good rule of thumb is to match the line width to your panels, making it uniform and all fit together. You should also carefully consider the different types of balloons and the tone they portray, then how and when to use them in your scenes. You can even experiment and add interesting combinations however they fit your story. For all balloons that have a direct speaker, you can use the balloon tail tool. When you create a tail, you want to make it obvious who is speaking, so my advice is to keep it aimed at the head of the character. Keep the tails at a consistent, even width all throughout, so not too thin and not too fat. Try also not to let it taper off into a tiny, thin line. Instead, keep it uniform and even. When you have multiple characters on the same page or panel, avoid crossing the streams. Consider creative ways to keep it obvious who's speaking without overlapping the tails, preventing confusing and messy dialogue. When you're ready to start adding text, you can go to your text tool, then click directly on the balloon, and it assigns your text to that bubble, meaning anytime you make adjustments or move the balloon around, the text stays inside. When formatting the text, you want it to fit inside the balloon. You do this by considering both size and stacking. The size of your text affects readability and also how much you can comfortably fit inside your word bubbles, and you want them neither too big nor too small. Too big and you won't have much room to fit your story, and too small and you risk either too much negative space or too many words in a single bubble. Take time to find a happy middle ground and keep it consistent. When you fit the text in the bubble, you need to create manual breaks in the lines and try to stack it in a way that keeps the width as even as possible. Once you've properly sized and stacked your text, consider the space it fills in the balloon. You neither want it too tightly packed nor have too much space. If you need to make edits after applying all of your text, you can access the entire script by going to Story, Edit Text, and Open Story Editor. Here, you can access the entire script you've already applied and make corrections if you need them. Consider giving your formatting a once-over once you're done. And that should do it. You've successfully lettered your comic. What's really wonderful about Clip Studio is that all these tools are available by default, and there's a large library of tools made by users for users, all available in the Clip Studio Asset Store. If you need more lettering examples, consider even looking at your favorite comic artist and mangaka and study their methods and see what's right for you. Although I believe ultimately the tools don't make the artist, Clip Studio makes the comic creating process incredibly streamlined and user-friendly for beginners and masters alike. I hope you found this video helpful, and I wish you luck on your comic journey. Thank you for watching, and until next time.